Jesus, and then we're going to move on from this place. God has been so good. How many know that the Lord has been good?
Yes, yes.
I'm looking at some blessed people. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Let's do I'm Chasing After You. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And we're going to give God praise and we're going to move on from this place. Thank you, Jesus. How many are God chasers in this room? Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And so we, hallelujah, run after him. We chase after him. Wherever he says for us to go, we're going to go that way. Hallelujah. We follow him. All right. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands. Hallelujah. Deacon Rogers being here. Amen. We praise God for that brother. Amen. He's faithful. He hangs with us. Hallelujah. But we don't want to weary his patience. We want to let him go ahead on about his business and enjoy his evening. Amen. But we came to give God praise. We got a little more time. Thank you, Jesus, to give God praise. We thank God for Pastor Scott being here. Amen. To preach the word. Amen. I was looking through his Facebook page and I saw some history in there, and I was like, well, thank you, Jesus. I think I got like a living legend type guy here. Amen. Amen. But he's seen a lot of stuff. I've been a part of a lot of things that have happened in this country, and I'm proud to know who he is. And I think, you know, sometimes we push each other sometimes into some good stuff and sometimes into some bad stuff. And we're supposed to be encouraging each other to do good things. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So he's one of those people that I think if we could push it, he could probably be a state representative or something like that. Congressman or something like that. Amen. Because he's seen a lot and he knows. And you know what? We as the people of God, we're supposed to be in those positions. We are world changers. Thank you, Jesus. You try to say, well, somebody else should do it. No, we are supposed to be the ones because we have the light.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
And sometimes our passivity is what causes us to be in certain situations that we're in now. But we need to be bold. The Bible says that the wicked fleeth when no man pursueth, but the righteous are as bold as a lion. So it's supposed to be us that go into those places. We're supposed to be taking Jesus into the marketplace. We're supposed to be taking Jesus into the places where we see, we know that there's darkness. And it's supposed to be leading us. Well, that means some of us should be in those places, amen, to lead. And I praise God. You said, well, why do you go like that? Because this is one of those people. I'm speaking it into existence right now. Hallelujah. This is one of those people. Come on, give God a praise. Maybe you don't know, but I know. I see it in the spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I thank God for what he's done, what he's doing right now, what he's going to do. He's going to do great things. I need you to jump up out of your seat and go shake hands with somebody that you don't know first. Hallelujah. And then thank you, Jesus. And Elder's sitting a lot, so I think he's a little tired. So I want y'all to make sure you hug him real good. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in you loves the Jesus in me. You're easy. Hallelujah to love. Come on, get up. Get out of your comfort zone. Hug somebody. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. Thank you.